all a very happy Independence Day. We all know that freedom was not achieved overnight, and it took over two centuries of struggle and sacrifice. On this occasion of the 75th Independence Day, let us commemorate some lesser known freedom fighters.
Yutirat Singh was the chief of Nongklaw in the Khasi Hills of present-day Meghalaya. He waged war on the British to prevent them from occupying the region. After the battle, he was captured and deported to Dhaka. He died in 1835. His death anniversary is celebrated as Yutirat Singh Day in Meghalaya. Begum Hazrat Mahal was a leading figure in the 1857 revolution, seizing Lucknow from the British. After a long siege, the British recaptured Lucknow and Mahal had to retreat to Nepal, where she spent the last years of her life. She died in 1878 in Kathmandu, where she was buried near the Jama Masjid. Matangini Hazra was an activist in the struggle for Indian independence. During a procession that she led, she continued to advance with the Indian flag even after being shot thrice. She died with the flag still held high and flying. She was called Gandhi Budi. Rani Chennamma was the queen of the princely state of Kittur in present-day Karnataka. She led an armed rebellion against the British East India Company in 1824 in defiance of an attempt to maintain Indian control over the region, but she was defeated and imprisoned. She died in prison in 1829. She is regarded as one of the first freedom fighters of India. Haibu Jadanang was a Rongmei Naga spiritual leader and activist who established the Horaka movement. The movement was widespread in Zhelyangrong territory. He was a staunch supporter of the independence of Nagas. This brought him into conflict with the British. He was hanged in 1931 at the age of 26. Bhikaiji Kama was a prominent figure in the Indian independence movement. At the Second Socialist Congress at Stuttgart, Germany, she became the first person to hoist the Indian flag on foreign soil. She also co-designed the nationalist flag that was raised at Stuttgart. This would later evolve into the current Indian flag. Tirupur Kumaran was the founder of the Desha Bandhu Youth Association. He led protests against the British. On 11th January 1932, he was brutally assaulted by the police during a protest march along the banks of the Noyal River. He died from injuries sustained from the assault. He was 27 years old. Velu Thampi was the Diwan of Travancore in present-day Kerala from 1802 to 1809. He is known for being one of the first people to rebel against the British East India Company's supremacy in India. In 1808, he along with the Diwan of Cochin led the Travancore Rebellion. This would go on until 1809. He committed suicide to evade capture. Let us salute the noble souls who have fought bravely and laid down their lives to achieve freedom for this glorious nation of ours. Bharat Mata Ki Jai!